Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today in this video I am going to show you how to install the latest version of WAMP Server, that is WAMP Server version 3.3.2 on a Windows operating system. And after that I am also going to show you how we can easily run a simple Hello World PHP program on our browser. So in the middle of the video you will be seeing we are facing one error. So I will show you how to resolve that error and how to install XAMPP successfully on your system. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee you that if you watch the video till the end, you will be successfully install your WAMP. And if you still face any issues, then you can always comment in our comment sessions. I'll try my best to help you. So without any delay, let's start our video. Now to install WAMP Server, you need to first simply go to your favorite browser and you need to just simply search over here, WAMP Server Download, and hit enter. And you'll be seeing this www.wampserver.com as our first search result. So you have to click on this link and it's going to redirect to the official site of WAMP Server. So this link I'm going to put right in your description. So you can directly use that link to land over to this site. And here you can see start using WAMP Server. So just simply click on that. It's going to redirect to this 64-bit x64 3.3.2 WAMP Server. So I'm going to download this latest version. So just simply click on this. It's going to show you this page. You can always fill this form. I'm going to skip this, so I'll just simply click on you can download it directly, and it's going to redirect to the official site of SourceForgeNet. So here you can see we have WAMP Server. It will start within 5 seconds, and you can see that our WAMP Server is rightly started downloading, right? So I have already downloaded it, so I'll just simply cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that the same WAMP Server version 3.3.2 is already been downloaded over here. So to install it, just simply double click on the installer. It will ask you for administrative privileges. Click on yes, and let's minimize our download directory. So here it will ask you to select one language. So I'm going to select English. If you want to change it to France, you can do that. I'm going to select English. I'm going to click on OK. And you can see the license agreement. You can always read this license agreement, then you can always accept the license agreement. Click on next. So this is all the installation steps, totally fine. I'm going to show you everything on this video, so don't worry. So you need to just simply click on next over here. And now once you click on next, immediately can see this error, right? So here carefully if you read, you can see that VC 2010 SP1 redistributable x64 Visual C++ 2010 SP1 redistributable package is not installed, right? Similar to this, if you check all the followings, you can see 2010, then 2010 for both x64 and x86. Similarly, 2012, again x64, x86, then again x64 is not there. Similarly, then 2022, again x86 and x64 is not there. And for 2010, we don't have x64, right? Similarly, if you see for 2013 also, we don't have x64, right? So all these packages of Visual C++ is what it is recommending us to install, right? So it is very important. So I'm going to show you all of that, don't worry. So first you need to click on OK. And here you can see we have a link. So you need to open that link. Again, this link I'm going to also put in our description. You can also use that from our description link, and immediately you'll be landed over to this site. So here you need to scroll down right at the bottom, and you can see we have all VC redistributable packages available for x86 and x64 for Windows 32 and 64 bits, right? So you need to click on this link, and it will going to download all our VC redistributable packages. So you can see it rightly started. It's just a 100 MB file, so let's download it. And you can see our file is rightly downloaded over here. So let's go to our download directory. I'll minimize this. I'll go to our download directory. And here you can see is our package. So just simply right click and extract this. So extract. And it is rightly extracted over here. You can see we have all the packages now downloaded. But now it's time to install. So remember what we needed to install. So we needed to install 2010. So I'm going to select, and you can take a snapshot. All right, so these are all files that we need to install. All right, so you can see 2022, this x64, x86, then 2010, this SP1 x86 and then again 2010 x64, so these two files, then again 2012 all the files x64 and x86, and for 2013 only this one. Alright, so let's install all the things one by one. So I'll start from 2010. So administrative privileges, click on yes and it's going to install it. I have accept the terms and condition install and it's going to install. So installation is complete. So let's go to our 2013. So remember, all this is what we need to install. So we'll start from x64. Accept the license agreement, install, click on yes, and it is installed. Switch to 2012, accept the license agreement, install, give administrative privileges, setup is successful, install next one, accept the license agreement, install, give administrative privileges, setup is successful, then 2010, click on yes to give administrative privileges, accept the license agreement, yes, installation is complete, 2022, click on yes, setup is in progress, now done, now x64, click on install, give administrative privileges, so setup is successful. So now we can see that all our packages are rightly installed. So setup is successful and it is telling you must restart your computer before you can use the software. So restart is very important after installing all the Visual C++ versions. So let's restart our system, close all the directories. I'll also close our WAMP server, click on cancel, yes. So close everything, restart your system, and after successfully restarting our system, I'm going to again back to this video. So we'll come back. So after successfully restarting your system, we'll be again landed over to the desktop. So let's go back to our download directory, and you can see we have already WAMP server. So after successfully installing all Visual C++ distributions, it's time to install our WAMP server. So just simply double click on the WAMP server and you need to give administrative privileges, click on yes, and let's minimize our download directory again. So here again I'm not going to repeat, just simply click on OK, accept the license agreement, click on next. So again click on next, and this time you are seeing that we are not getting any errors, right? Because all of our Visual C++ distributions are successfully installed now. So now clearly we can proceed with the installation. So you can see here it's going to create our WAMP server directory folder, which is totally fine. Just simply click on next. So now we can see it is rightly started installing our WAMP server. So it will take some time, about 5 minutes I would say. So you can grab some coffee or tea, whatever you like, and again you can come back to this video. I'll be doing the same. So welcome back once again. So now you can see that our setup is almost completed, but it is asking to select one browser. So Edge I'm going to select, so just default browser, yes. And now it is asking to select that .exe, so I'll just going to click on open. So it's going to select our Edge, Microsoft Edge, as a default browser. You can always change to any other browser, not a problem. And again it is asking to select Notepad as a default browser or not. For that also I'm going to click on yes. So notepad.exe will be our default text editor. So just simply click on open and it's going to finish up our installing WAMP server. And here you can just simply click on next. So completing WAMP server 64 setup, just simply click on finish, and you can see that a WAMP is rightly installed. So our desktop shortcut is also created over here. So just simply double click on the shortcut, just simply give administrative privileges, and WAMP will start our services. And now if you go to this icon, you can see we have this WAMP turned into green, right? So you can always drag this and you can place right next to your microphone icon. So it is rightly there. So initially what happens is it usually becomes red and then it turns into yellow, and after that it turns into green. So once it is green, then you just know that our server is properly up and running. Alright, so you can see all services are running. Alright, so once you see it is turned into green, it's time to code. So let's first go to our C drive. And you'll be seeing our WAMP64 folder rightly created over here. So just simply go inside that folder. And here within this www folder, we need to create some projects. So always remember this www folder is a very important folder for a WAMP server. If you are using XAMPP, then htdocs folder is the folder through which we communicate. And for WAMP, it is www folder. Alright. So let's, you know, right click and create a new folder, and I'm going to name this folder as php-practice. Alright, and then I'm going to go inside that folder, and here I'm going to create a new text document. So I'm going to give the text document name as hello world, and I'm going to change this .txt extension with .php and hit enter. So just simply click on yes, and you can see that our hello world.php is rightly created. So if you don't able to see this .php or .txt sort of extension, then all you need to do is you need to click on this view and then you need to hover over the show and you need to enable this file name extensions. So once you enable that, you will be seeing properly this file name extensions right after the file name. Alright, so once you see that, just simply open that file in our notepad, and here let's write a simple PHP code snippet. So angular bracket PHP, and I'm going to end the tag, and here I'm going to simply echo hello world. Alright, hello world. So now I'm just going to go to file and save this file, right? And if I go to browser and just simply open a new tab and just simply type over here localhost and just simply hit enter, you'll be able to see properly that WAMP server localhost is rightly opened over here, right? So now you need to go inside this PHP practice folder. So just whatever the folder name, so that same thing you need to type over here. So slash php-practice, right? So that is our folder name. Hit enter, and immediately whatever there inside our this PHP practice folder will be showing up over here. So here is our hello world.php, right? So that file is properly showing. So now if you just simply click on this file, you can see the output clearly on our browser, right? So whatever you are typing, let's say you have modified this hello world to hello everyone, and you are going to save this file, and if you just simply refresh this, now you can see hello everyone on our browser, right? So in this way you can easily install WAMP server. I have also showed you how you can easily resolve that error and how to properly install WAMP server, how to create project. Everything I have showed you on this video. I know the video is a bit long, but I hope the video is helping you. And I have also started a Geeky Syntax channel. So here regularly I'm posting coding related videos. So if you are more into programming and coding, and if you want more videos, then please do subscribe this channel as well. That will really motivate me to make more such videos. And I have also started a Geeky Script vlogging channel, so if you're interested, you can also subscribe this channel as well, right? So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.